Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss regarding the moving coil ballistic galvanometer. Moving coil ballistic galvanometer, which is an instrument used to measure the charge. Okay, why we use a ballistic galvanometer? To measure the charge. Okay, so if we consider a condenser capacitor, okay, if we charge that capacitor, how much charge in that capacitor? Okay, we can measure by using ballistic galvanometer. For example, if you take a battery cell, okay, how much charge in that battery we can measure by using ballistic galvanometer. Ballistic galvanometer is a sensitive device. Okay, when any charge passes through ballistic galvanometer, what happens? The galvanometer will be whatever the coil inside the galvanometer will be twisted, it will do angular accelerations. And by whatever the deflection, we are getting the maximum deflection in that coil, okay, by through which we can find the charge passing through the ballistic galvanometer. Okay, so here, see that whatever the construction here, it consists of what? A rectangular coil PQRS. Okay, and this rectangular coil is suspended in a, what we can say, horseshoe magnet we are using to maintain the radial magnetic field around the coil. Here we are taking PQRS, a rectangular coil in which we have more number of tons, okay, and this coil is wound on the wooden, what we can say, bamboo stick or ivory. Okay, it is a material which is a non-conducting material. On non-conducting material, we will wound the whatever the coil. Okay, right. So the number of tons in the coil are more in number. Okay, and it is suspended in between the horseshoe magnet by which phosphorus bronze wire. We are suspending this whatever the rectangular coil in the magnetic field by using bronze wire. This wire, the suspension wire, the top of the suspension wire is connected to T1 torsional head, and the whatever the other end of the bronze wire is connected to spring and is connected to T2. Okay, between T1 and T2, the rectangular coil is suspended. Here, the phosphorus bronze wire, we are connecting a mirror here. Here, the mirror is adjusted so that by using the Lampine scale arrangement, we can find the deflections in the coil. Okay, Lampine scale arrangement, right? By using Lampine scale arrangement, we can find the deflections in the coil by using a mirror, right? Now, actually, the moving coil by ballistic galvanometer, okay, it is a sensitive device. When a charge passing through that moving galvanometer, it will, whatever the coil inside the galvanometer will be deflect. Okay, so the charge is directly proportional to deflection, maximum deflection. Okay, so we are going to find that charge here. We are going to find the expression for charge. Okay, for that purpose here, see, if you come to the mathematical part, here if any rectangular coil is placed in a high magnetic field, what happens? It will be twisted, it will be rotated. That twist is nothing but what? Torque. Okay, we have direct expression here for torque. When any coil is placed in magnetic field, okay, what happens? It will rotate, it will do angular oscillations, nothing but what? Torque, couple force, right? So the torque expression is what? Tau is equal to NIAB. What is N? N is number of turns in the coil, and I is the current passing through the coil. Whatever the current, how we can find the current here? Varying current, alternating current, because the charge is passing through the galvanometer with respect to time, nothing but we will get a current here. Okay, so that current, I is nothing but our current, A is the area of the coil, and B is the magnetic field induction. Okay, this is the readymade and direct expression, that is torque tau is equal to N into I into AB. NI AB, we have to remember this. Okay, now after this, see, when any torque acting per sudden short interval of time on the coil, nothing but what? It is nothing but what? Impulse, angular impulse. If any, for example, if any torque acting on a coil for a short interval of time, this is nothing but what? Impulse force, angular impulse force. So, what is impulse here? Angular impulse? Simply it is torque into time, couple into time, or torque into time. So, torque or couple into time. For short interval of time, if any object is rotated for short interval of time, that is nothing but what? Angular impulse, which is nothing but torque into short interval of time. So NIAB into dt, NIAB into dt. Now this is angular impulse. Now for total time interval t, the total angular impulse is given by integration of this expression NIAB integration 0 to t i dt. What is integration 0 to t i dt? I nothing but what? Current. Current is equal to charge per time. I is equal to Q by T. Okay, so Q is equal to I T. So integration of I dt gives what? Q. So, but angular impulse. See, the total angular impulse becomes what? NAB into Q. NAB into Q. But this angular impulse is nothing but what? If any object is rotating, nothing but what? It have angular momentum. This angular impulse must be equal to angular momentum. So NABQ is equal to I omega. Angular momentum. Momentum nothing but what? Mass into velocity. Here mass in rotated motion, mass nothing but what? Inertia. And velocity, V is nothing but what? Angular velocity, that is omega. So I into omega. This angular impulse must be equal to I omega. So NABQ is equal to I omega. If any object is moving, rotating, nothing but what? It having kinetic energy. How much kinetic energy it has? Half I omega square. Half I omega square. Here what we are going to find? We are going to find the charge passing through that ballistic galvanometer, that coil. Okay? For that purpose we are considering all these things. Okay? Here, kinetic energy half M, half I omega square. This kinetic energy is used to rotate the coil. Okay, when the charge is passing through the coil, it will be rotated. Nothing but what? It has some kinetic energy. The decrease in kinetic energy is nothing but what? Why? Whatever the kinetic energy is used to do the work. What work it is used to rotate the coil? Okay, by the mean position. So, whatever the kinetic energy in this coil will be used to do some work. Okay, that work done. If theta naught is the maximum twist. Here we are going to find the maximum displacement, maximum angular displacement. So the charge is directly proportional to maximum displacement here. Okay, we are going to prove that. So the how much deflection, more charge is passing through the galvanometer, like that. Okay, so whatever the kinetic energy is converted into work, here work, converted into work. See, if C is the couple per twist, unit twist, C is the couple force per unit twist, okay, unit twist nothing but what? Angle. Okay, so the work is nothing but what? C into theta. If C is the couple force into displacement is nothing but what? Work. In rotatory motion displacement is theta, so force nothing but couple force C into theta, nothing but what? Work C into theta. For small work it will becomes what? C theta dt. For small displacement of d theta, the total work is given by c theta d theta. For maximum deflection theta naught, the total work done is given by 0 to theta naught c theta d theta, where c is the couple per unit twist. Okay, and c into theta is nothing but what? Work done. C theta into d theta is for small work done for small angular displacement. So the total work done is 0 to theta naught, where theta naught is a maximum twist. So the work done is given by half C theta naught square. Now, what about the kinetic energy? Half I omega square is converted into work done. Work done is how much? Half I omega square is equal to half c theta naught square. It is come from the above expression, total work done. Okay, so half c theta naught square. Like this, we will get the work done. Okay, so half I omega square is equal to half c theta naught square. Now, if theta is equal to 2 pi under root, here see, the time period of this angular acceleration is given by t is equal to 2 pi under root I by c. I is the moment of inertia and c is the coupling. Okay, this is direct expression. The time period of oscillation, this is direct expression. So t is equal to 2 pi under root I by c. From this expression you will get I is equal to almost pi by motion, you will get t square c by 4 pi square. Okay, t square, I is equal to t square c by 4 pi square. Now, squaring the equation 1 here, whatever the angular impulse is equal to angular momentum, NAPQ is equal to I omega is equation 1. Now, squaring this, what will get? Squaring on both sides, N square, A square, B square, Q square is equal to I square, omega square. Now, squaring this equation, I am dividing by equation 2. Where is equation 2 here? See, from this, dividing equation, from this equation, we will get I here. How much? Half of will be cancelled. I is equal to how much? C theta naught square by omega square. I is equal to how much? C theta naught square by omega square. Let us consider. Or we can write I omega square is equal to C theta naught square. Half of cancel. I omega square is equal to C theta naught square. Let us consider it as equation 2. Now divide equation, square the equation 1 and divide it by 2. What will you get? See, what will you get here? So I omega square is equal to C theta naught square is equation 2. Now divide this equation 2 by squaring equation 1 on both sides. We will get squaring by equation of 1. What? N, N square, A square, B square, Q square is equal to I square omega square divided by C theta naught square is equal to I omega square. I omega square, I omega square cancel. I can get cancel. We will get at last I is equal to how much? I is equal to N square, A square, B square, Q square by C theta naught square. This is I. Okay, let us consider it as equation 4. Comparing equation 3 and 4. From equation here, see t is equal to 2 pi under I by c. This is direct expression. From this you will get I is equal to t square c by 4 pi square. Let us consider equation 3. Okay. Now comparing equation 3 and 4. What will you get? Comparing equation 3 and 4. So comparing equation 3 and 4. T square c square by 4 pi square is equal to n square a square b square q square by c theta naught square. Okay, so from this we will get q square is equal to how much? T square c theta naught square by 4 pi square n square a square b square. Okay, n square a square b square square send that side. This will become c into c square. So t square c square. Okay, at last, after solving this, we will get q is equal to t by 2 pi. Okay, at last we will get t by 2 pi. T by 2 pi into c by t by 2 pi into c by NAP. NAP into theta naught. Okay, at last, after solving this, we will get how much q is equal to t by 2 pi into c by NAP into theta naught. Here, nothing but what? Q is equal to some k into theta naught coulombs. Okay, this k value is how much? K is equal to how much here? So, at last k is equal to how much? T by 2 pi c by NAP Okay, so Q is equal to K into theta naught. Nothing but what? Q is directly proportional to theta naught. Nothing but charge is directly proportional to maximum deflection. That's what we proved here. So we got Q value as 3 by 2 pi C into theta naught by NEB. We can find like this the how much charge in the condenser. Okay, why we use ballistic galvanometer? To measure the self-induction. To measure the mutual induction. Okay. And to measure what charge in the conductors and to measure the EMF, thermo EMF. So this is the ballistic galvanometer, Wuing Kai ballistic galvanometer. Okay, so like this we can find the charge here. So the according to this, the charge is directly proportional to maximum displacement. Very very important question, previously asked question. Listen carefully and write down the notes and send me by email. Okay, thank you.